We want to talk about the fear of God. I want you to know that the fear of God is the beginning of knowledge and wisdom. If you want to be blessed by God, if you want to enjoy your good blessings, you have to learn to fear God. God needs to be feared. You have to fear God. You have to pray to be good. Of course, we are the righteousness of God. Jesus Christ, He paid for our sins. So we are blameless. So, if you want to be blessed, you have to know that you are supposed to seek here first the kingdom of God. You know, me, I regret sometimes in my life that it was I wasted my time doing worldly things. You know, praying to God is sweetie. You enjoy the blessings of God. Blessings will follow you. Man will follow you. Right? You will identify different spirits. You will be a blessing in your family. Everyone wants to be attached to you. Everyone wants to be connected to you. You know, you become the pillar of strength in your family when you've got God. But then if you don't have God, oh, it's difficult, you know. You struggle. You think maybe God is pulling. You see, you struggle. You can't sleep when you're in debt. You know, you can't do anything when you don't have God. And you have to know that I want to encourage someone. Whoever told you that money is not good did lie to you. Money is good. God wants us to be abundantly blessed. You know, it is God's wish for you to be blessed. That is why you even see friends of God like Abraham. They were blessed. They were very much blessed. They had thousands of cattle, cows, those cows. You know, they had thousands of sheep, plenty of servants, vast lands to take care of their flocks. So it is actually God's desire for you to be blessed. Whoever tells you that money is not good, right? Of course, we know that the love of money is the root of all evil. You don't have to be greedy with money. You don't have to love money up to an extent that you do unscrupulous activities. But what we are saying, it is God's desire for you to be successful. It is God's desire for you to be abundantly blessed. Because when God blesses you, you can also bless others. You can identify orphans and take care of them. You can identify those who are in need. You might be having a good heart, but then if you don't have, what can you give? How can you give if you don't have? You can only give if you don't have. There is no way to give. So we have to fear God. There are three areas that we usually struggle in life. Financially, he wants you to be broke, he wants you to be in dangerous situations. But you have to identify, you have to open your eyes. This is a season whereby you are expected to open your eyes. Right? If you open your eyes, God is really with you. If you open your eyes, God will never leave you. I have seen someone who is faithful and God never was with him. You know, our God is a God of miracles. Even if you see certain prophets, pastors, It's only that some of them, they end up like into too much body things. But God would have blessed them. Because our God is a faithful God. He's not a God who is unjust. Our God is a God who is fair.